how I'm missing clubbing at the moment and really missing DJing. That's the main thing, DJing. I pronounced that really weird, didn't I? But I'm missing being there behind the decks in some dingy, poorly lit club somewhere, you know, getting up to all sorts of nonsense. That's what I basically miss, I think, from now on. I think I'm approaching that mark where this new reality that we're now getting used to, I'm kind of a bit bored of it. I'm like, you know what, enough. Let's just go back to normal, have some kind of normality. But again, I think I've come to a realization as well, by the by, that's not going to happen. It's not going to go back to normal again. We're going to have to operate in some sort of new normality that's probably going to delay a lot of the things that we know and love. So there has to be a compromise to be reached, some sort of middle ground needs to be reached, whether it's a warehouse rave, a house party, something needs to happen that I can go and pump my fist up in the air or shake my head like I just don't care. And you know, actually thinking about it, if and when that happens, I made a commitment to myself not to leave the dance floor for at least 4 hours, standard. No toilet, no getting another drink, not going out to get some fresh air, just pure unadulterated, sweating myself out, dancing on all the good vibes and all the good energy for everyone around me for a good 4 hours minimum. That's my commitment I'm making to myself, because god damn it, man. Especially when you start watching live streams, it's just I guess as an up and coming or as a budding DJ, for me, the DJ, you know, watching a DJ live stream is pretty helpful, right? You get some tips and tricks about, you know, how to mix or how to blend, different kind of how they basically phrase mixes together, the structures, the looping techniques, all these little cool things that you can learn by watching somebody play live on a live stream, right? But if you're somebody that's really about this culture and you love it for real, there's gonna be a part of you that's gonna be like, god damn it, I just long for just being on the other side of the decks, just dancing. You're not even going to be bothered about playing somewhere. You're going to be like, I just want to be in that environment, right? That's what usually happens. When you get the bug of wanting to be involved in nightlife, it usually starts from just being a punter, just going out, meeting people, hanging out in cool places, being part of the scene. And then suddenly, like, you know what? He or she looks at me. I can do this too. You put on your first night. You whack something up in Paint or in Photoshop as a flyer. You put it out there with your friends. You invite all your friends to come down on Facebook. None of them turn up, right? But you just keep doing it anyway because you love it so much. And then it turns into something that you end up, you know, committing, you know, the best part of 10 plus years to, right? Which I have been doing. So the DJing part of it is like a little treat on top. You know, that's not really the thing that you're actually looking forward to. The thing you're looking forward to is actually the connection with people, going to new and interesting places. I know that's what the main crux of it was for me, being able to go to, like, you know, have a weekend and go and visit some cool clubs in Berlin, cool clubs in Frankfurt, go somewhere in Bristol, Brighton, Newcastle, Manchester, Liverpool, right? All these mad places I've been to just for the rave. So it does expand your horizons in that way. So you can just imagine what that must be like for people like myself who has spent the last 3 months. Again, admittedly, you know, I'm not the only one that's suffering through this. Other people are in much worse conditions than I am, or in far worse conditions than I am. I know that, but god damn it, man. To have all that, to be used to so much visual stimuli and audio stimuli, and to suddenly be just at home, you know, locked indoors, not being able to kind of replicate that anywhere else, is really hard to take, especially because I'm trying to be careful. I think if this was a few years back, I would have done everything in my power to just be like, you know what, F that, I'm going outside, I'm gonna go get loose, I'm gonna go get crazy. But I'm a bit older now, I'm maturing, I hope, right, little by little, and I'm doing things the right way, and I'm like, you know what, no, Agostino, you don't do that. You wait until it's safe, and until you've been told to go out, then you go out. And that's what I'm trying to do at the moment. But god damn, it's hard. I tell you that right now, it's bloody difficult. And I'm sure other people are in the same place. I can assume it. Even imagine if you're like an actual touring DJ, how this must feel then. You just, because I've read so many horror stories about, you know, not horror stories, but so many heartbreaking stories about DJs who just got, I think I read one account of some girl who just, I don't know, she just moved out to her own place. She was due to do a whole season of touring basically up until September. I think maybe in that residency, in that beef and some other things. And then COVID hit, and suddenly she's back living with her mum, trying to figure out if she's even going to go back to music when everything opens up again. Because that's the thing people are not talking about either. It's all well and good us having a break, but are there going to be any of these spots available when it reopens? Will the club still want to book you? Will they want to pay you even, right? Will it be oversubscribed? Because essentially, if no one can tour, that means everyone that's not touring will be at home and they'll be hitting up the clubs wanting to get spots. And they're probably, I don't know, maybe a couple of levels or a couple more years experience further along than I am. They might get more preferential treatment because, you know, if you're a bar owner and suddenly some guy that was touring all over Europe, you know, has a fucking mixed features on RA, suddenly wants to hit you up and play in your little bar somewhere in King's Cross, you're going to be over the moon. And he's happy to take 200 quid just so you can get back behind the decks playing again. You're going to take him over me any day of the weekend. So it's going to be a really hard slog for people fighting it out for gigs, like, you know, like it always is, right? Because, you know, being a DJ isn't the most complicated thing in the world. It's probably the job with the, you know, lowest bar of entry in terms of entertainment, I'd say, right? You can, it's probably difficult, it's really, you know, unless you've got a voice, it's hard to sing and, you know, and be a compelling artist that people actually give a fuck about. Unless you can rap as well, it's the same sort of thing. Unless you can play an instrument, you've got to devote a lot of time to that as well. I guess you only, you know, a good easy way to come into music or to get into entertainment would be to be like, I don't know, a harmonizing backup singer, right? You don't have to be that good of a singer, but of course you have to sing. And then, and you got a job for life, basically. Especially if you're a cool person, people will just keep using you again and again, and then essentially DJing, because you play other people's music. All you have to learn is how to beat match, essentially, and develop good taste in music, which, you know, it's easy to do too. If you care about it, you'll develop good taste in music. And if you don't care, you can just play the top 100 of Beatport. So it is the lowest bar of entry in terms of entertainment. So you can just imagine how packed it's going to be, how competitive it's going to be actually between people in terms of getting gigs. But on the other side of things, it might also be a great time. There might be a time of abundance, because there might be loads of really interesting spots that open up that basically serve people's needs. Because I think people will just be happy just to leave the house. I know I will, once things get, you know, flowing again, just so I can just, you know, imagine, grab a book and go to Starbucks after work or something. That'll be sick. So people will, I assume, would want to do the same thing, right? Instead of hanging out inside on a Tuesday at 2 p.m, they'll go somewhere else and, you know, work up their laptop and work from there, have somebody playing some cool chill beats in the background or something, right? As people are milling around, going in and out, I can imagine that happening. But we have to wait and see, innit? We have to wait and see. But let's get into it. I think I've got a list here actually from RA that details some of the things that's going on in the world. Let's see what the plans are and how things are opening up in terms of dance line culture, because I've, you know, woke up today, thought, you know what, I need to check out what's going on in the scene. Am I missing something? Because there's part of me that's thinking, you know what, there might be an opportunity if things open up in like Germany or something, to go for like a quick trip to Berlin for the weekend, or to go somewhere like Bristol and just hang out. That might be a thing if things open up, especially somewhere where there's a lot more open, a lot more, not also open spaces, but there's a lot more places that have gardens and shit, and places that you can just chill at. Because in London, that's the difficult part, right? There's not many, I don't know, the spots that you want to go to are going to be crowded, and it's hard to kind of figure out. But let's see what the plan, what is looking like across the country. So this is from RA. How countries plan to restart nightclubs and festivals, and they keep updating this every day whenever they can. Last update was Thursday. Switzerland, they're saying the Switzerland Federal Council has increased the maximum number of people allowed to attend indoor gatherings from 300 to 1,000. Of course, you heard me mention that before, based on what what's his face was doing. Luciano was at Weetamix, right? Is that what it's called? Weetamix. And he played just the other day. This is a video from the night, actually. How fun does that look? So Luciano played that club called Weetamix in Switzerland. I'm assuming he's back home now due to COVID, so that's a good thing. So, you know, imagine seeing imagine seeing a DJ of Luciano's level playing in a club that has only 300 people in it. What a treat, innit? What a treat. So, it says 1,000 with no social distancing, according to the government site. It says the decision, which applies to concert halls, theatres and cinemas, does contain some limitations aimed at slowing the spread. In cases where the attendance exceeds 300 people, audiences will have to be separated by partitions and rooms holding up to 300. Okay, cool. That makes sense. That's a pretty good idea. Be a bit weird though, innit? Little clusters of 300 people. That can't necessarily pass each other, I'd assume. Events with more than 1,000 people remain banned until August 31st, 2020. Okay, that's plus one from Switzerland. What's happening in Netherlands? As of Netherlands aren't booking any black people, but let's see what they're doing in terms of lifting restrictions. It said, as of June 24th, the Dutch government has increased the number of people allowed in indoor spaces from 30 to 100. That's an amazing jump there, provided guests have their own seats. For outdoor venues, the limit exceeds 250. Said these capacity restrictions do not apply when an establishment can require prior reservations, compulsory seating and health checks on the door. The current ban on nightclubs and discos, however, remains in place until September. So they've got some firm dates there, right? Switzerland's August 31st, it says there, right? August 31st, and then Netherlands is September 1st. I wish we had some dates in mind. We don't really have any dates. We've got the dates for the pubs opening. There's no dates for the gym. Suppose I've heard it's the 8th, the following weekend. But that's the issue. There's no real kind of plan in place about how we go about doing it. I kind of understand because of the numbers are peaking and they don't really want to, you know, give people any encouragement to get naughty. But I'd love to have some dates out there for the British public so we can understand what's going on, man. Going crazy in here. So it continues to say that Belgium has eased lockdown restrictions and will go into effect as of July 1st in Belgium. Reuters reports the new rules allow venues to hold indoor events up to 200 people and outdoor events of up to 400 with the requirement social distancing hygiene measures are observed. We are still not safe from the rebound of the epidemic, says the country's prime minister Sophie Wilmers. This summer will have a peculiar taste in this. Talking about the capacity size, I'd imagine with that most venues will have to sell tickets ahead of time. There'll be you won't be able to buy tickets at the door, I'd assume, right? Just so they can make sure they have a handle on the numbers. And then the good thing is that venues won't be allowed to do that thing where they oversell tickets, so they're gonna have to stick with selling the amount of tickets that they're allowed to have people inside, right? It's gonna have to correlate. There's not gonna be any grace either side, which will be great. But I guess if you're looking for a spontaneous night out, not probably the thing. But I guess the good thing is because everyone's been indoors for 3 months, getting your friends together to go somewhere would be a lot easier because, you know, they literally got nothing to do. So no one can make any excuses. And I'm assuming a lot of people are driving themselves out the wall as well. So that should be cool. United Kingdom, UK has announced new guidances. I don't think we've got anything new, actually. Plan to rebuild what they're saying here. 60 pair. I don't see any dates, just loads of stuff regarding what we're planning to do. Germany, they said the Berlin Senate has lifted all contact restrictions, which will take effect from Saturday, June 27th. Outdoor events with more than 1,000 capacity are banned through to August 31st. Then the capacity limit is raised to 5,000 through October 24th. Indoor events cannot exceed 300 through July 31st, and September indoor capacity limit is raised to 250. German government has committed to providing 1 billion to the cultural sector with more than 150 million lot specifically for live music. Wow. Germany has also allowed for all shops to reopen with social distancing measures, which has been good news for the country's record stores. Some Berlin clubs, including Sisyphos, reopened as of Friday, May 15th, as afternoon beer gardens operating on a food license. The state of Bavaria also reopened restaurants. Nationwide, Germany holds a ban on clubs, theatres and culture events until July 31st. So I'd be interested to see what happens after July. Will they open things up and allow people to put on events? Probably, judging by what they're saying, they're probably going to allow people to do like what 1,000 capacity events will be able to be done by then. I don't know, maybe less than 1,000. So that could be a way to go in there. What's happening with America here? Uneven effort, of course. Austin, Texas, and Springfield, Kentucky, pushing to open bars and meet eminently. It said the world's largest concentration of infection and deaths reopening efforts in cities like New York and Los Angeles will be carried out in phases, which makes sense. New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio announced the city will be moving into a second phase of its reopening beginning on Monday, 22nd of June. Okay, this means that the restaurants and bars with outdoor seating will be allowed to serve spaced out tables. Customers will be required to wear masks when not at their table. Ohio Music Festival SDKs suing state county officials over the deemed baseless ban on large events during pandemic, IQ reports. Wow, an event is suing the state. That's insane. Good luck on that one. Spain was the same. Bars and nightclubs are allowed to reopen from June the 8th as Spain enters phase three. Okay, interesting. So they already opened their bars and nightclubs, it says. However, dancing is not allowed. Okay, fair enough. It's similar to Sisyphos and the German bars. It says from May 21st, outdoor events of up to 400 people. Capacity events are allowed to resume. The Festival Kerala, whose 2020 edition was meant to occur July 4th, has announced a major initiative called Kerala XXS, a series of 200 open events set to take place in July across Barcelona in venues such as the Design Museum of Barcelona and the gardens of the Catalan National Theatre. From July to the 1st, Spain will allow international visitors into the country, which would be a big one, I think. Also, and without a required quarantine period. I guess it's a shame there's no Ibiza, so you're not going to be able to rescue your summer that way. But if you want to just hang out and go to, you know, go on a bit of a pub crawl, eat some amazing food, catch some rays, get a bit of a tan, it's well worth it, I think. I think prices will still be fairly cheap as well. So, again, there is some... you know, it's a shame clubs are not open, but again, I think if you really do want to have a late holiday, you can still do it, especially if you're working from home. You can, you know, probably squeeze in a couple of days either side. Australia, what they're doing here, they're saying that Australia and New South Wales, the home state of Sydney, nightclubs could be allowed to open as early as August. Well, if the community transmission rates are kept low, although 4 square meter per person rule to allow for social distancing is likely to be enforced. And New Zealand, after 2 weeks of lockdown, New Zealand Prime Minister announced that June 8th that all COVID restrictions, aside from international border controls, will be lifted. Wow, they're so happy over there. Portugal, Iceland, a few more there. I'm not going to read the whole thing, but God, man, it's just, yeah, you just have to be patient and wait. And I guess I might, and I'm just talking to myself about that, really. I'm not trying to convince you guys, but God damn it, man. Wish things could get back to normal sooner rather than later, but, you know, what can we do?